welcome to another episode of Science Monitor, a show that brings to you the most significant news from the world of science, technology, innovation, research, discoveries, and much more. I'm Aishwarya Kapoor, and here are this week's headlines. Scientists improve camera traps for a more accurate tiger count in the Sundarbans Biosphere Reserve, a step towards protecting their population. Professor Alok Paul at the Indian Institute of Science, Bengaluru, awarded the prestigious Shanti Swarup Bhatnagar Prize 2017 in Engineering Sciences for his notable contributions for developing new industrial materials. As Wildlife Month comes to an end, the Zoological Survey of India publishes the first record of biodiversity of the Great Nicobar Islands. Ramanujan Fellowship provided by CERB open for Indian scientists across the world. A top story this week. Tigers have been on the planet for over 2 million years. But ironically, in the last 100, they have been reduced to a few thousand due to hunting and loss of habitat. One of the largest concentration of tigers are in the Sundarban National Park, a World Heritage Site, and a biosphere reserve in the West Bengal Gangetic Delta and adjacent to Bangladesh. Until now, the thick mangrove forests and the changing tides made it difficult for the forest department and scientists to count the number of tigers here. But a solution has been found. Science Monitor brings you this report.
Given the inaccessible landscape of the Ganges Delta, with mangroves and thick deciduous forests, the famed and elusive Sundarban tigers are difficult to study and track. The exercise to count their numbers is therefore a time-consuming and difficult task. The traditional methodology by identifying pug marks or the more recent technique of studying fecal DNA are difficult due to high and low tides that occur at intervals of 12 hours. Several attempts were also made by the forest officials to set up camera traps, but all in vain, as saline water spoiled the devices. These camera traps were then placed at knee height to capture the movement and behavior of tigers. In 2014, after several attempts of trial and error, forest officials placed these traps at a strategic location of 40 to 50 centimeters above the ground, where they can function properly irrespective of the tides in the forests. These installed camera traps revealed 87 photographs of adult tigers.
The methodology used for the tiger census India is one of the best and state-of-art which have been used by the National Tiger Conservation Authority as well as Wildlife Institute of India. Since they are utilizing the camera trap method as well as some supporting methodology like genetic assessment, then habitat assessment.
Now, to keep track of activities and behavior patterns of wild animals, various devices like camera traps and radio collars are used. Camera traps are secretive cameras equipped with a motion sensor or an infrared sensor that uses a light beam as a trigger. The device captures the image and sends the information to a software. This software then uses the statistical information based on the number of days and images to give the exact number of tiger count. The unique pattern of stripes on a tiger's body helps in identifying them. This process also helps the authorities to know the exact number of adult tigers. The trap also helps to find out the number of different species in the area, their behavior pattern, and migratory process.
As far as the census of tiger is concerned, from all 50 tiger reserve, if you compare the data from 2006 onwards, 1,411 tigers were reported in 2006. Then in 2010, 1,706 tigers were reported, and after that in 2014, 2,226 individuals have been known from the country.
With the help of these camera traps, about 24 tigers were spotted in the South Paragna's Forest Division, outside the Sundarban Tiger Reserve area. In another region, images of 16 adult tigers were captured in the National Park East Range, 19 in West Range and 15 in Bashirhat Range and the Sajnekali Wildlife Sanctuary. Satellite-based radio collars fitted with a small transmitter and a battery is another device used to track wild animals living in dense vegetation, which enables researchers to continuously monitor the animal's movement. These methodologies of tiger counting are very helpful in monitoring and formulation of policies for preserving the natural habitat of the animal and preventing it from getting extinct.
Many industries, including oil and gas, electrical power plants and space technology, depend on heavy-duty equipment that can stand extreme heat, wear and tear and corrosion. So scientists across the globe are working to develop newer and better materials. Professor Alok Paul at the Indian Institute of Science Bengaluru has received the prestigious Shanti Swarup Bhatnagar Prize 2017 in the field of material sciences for his valuable contributions in this area. Professor Paul's research has improved the understanding of metals, which in turn has contributed to developing high-performance industrial materials. Science Monitor brings you this special report.
To achieve high speeds, aeroplanes require engines that are resistant to high friction, wear and tear, heat and corrosion. To make better engines, scientists are continuously searching for newer and improved materials. Alloys made by combining metals and non-metals or both in fixed proportion show immense potential in this area. For example, steel, which is an alloy made by combining iron, a metal, and carbon, a non-metal, has better strength than iron or carbon alone. This year, the Shanti Swarup Bhatnagar Prize, which is the highest honor in the field of science in India, has been awarded to Professor Alok Paul for his notable contribution in the field of materials engineering. His work has led to better understanding of metals, which has helped in making special materials called super alloys. Super alloys can be used for making high-performance engines, spacecrafts, and heavy-duty industrial equipment because they have high strength and are resistant to extreme heat and corrosion. This has been possible because Professor Alok Paul and his group elaborated the Kirkendall effect for the first time. This law has important practical applications in materials engineering. It states that the motion between two metal surfaces is a result of different rates of diffusion or movement of metal atoms. This law helps to prevent occurrence of voids or empty spaces between metal surfaces when they are mixed together to make alloys. This helps to make better super alloys, which, because of their superior properties, can be used in spacecrafts, electric power plants, and in petrochemical industry. Recently in 2016, his team developed a super alloy from nickel, copper and tin that shows high mechanical strength. By making newer super alloys, Professor Alok Paul has contributed in the field of material science in a big way. He graduated from the National Institute of Technology in Durgapur, West Bengal and proceeded to complete his master's in engineering from the Indian Institute of Science in Bangalore. He moved to Eindhoven University of Technology in the Netherlands for his doctoral studies and did postdoctoral work at the University of British Columbia in Canada. After returning to India in 2005, he joined his alma mater, the prestigious Indian Institute of Science, Bangalore, as a professor. Since then, he has been contributing research papers in the field of material sciences. Some aspects of his research have appeared in college textbooks. He has authored 4 books and has more than 60 papers to his credit. He continues to find newer materials to make better equipment and infrastructure for industries in India and across the world.
It's time for a short break, but when we return, we will take you to the Great Nicobar Islands, where for the first time, the Zoological Survey of India has published a comprehensive list of the island's biodiversity. All those details after a short break.
We'll be right back. I am Raj Paroda. I am going to talk to you about challenges before Indian agriculture. How successfully we can meet them through scientific initiatives and efforts. Please watch Eureka.
Welcome back after the break. You're watching Science Monitor. The Great Nicobar Island, situated in the Andaman and Nicobar group of islands in the Indian Ocean, is a unique biodiversity hotspot of our country. It has nearly 1,800 species of animals and microbes, of which many are endemic to this region. In an initiative to conserve the biodiversity of the Great Nicobar Island, the Zoological Survey of India has for the first time published a book that records the biodiversity of this region. The book will serve as a ready manual for scientists and researchers to conserve the biodiversity of this unique island. Science Monitor brings you this report.
The Zoological Survey of India, Port Blair and Kolkata have published the first official record of the biodiversity of India's Great Nicobar Island. With an endeavor to preserve the unique biodiversity of this region, this book lists all animals and microbial species found on this island. It is entitled Faunal Diversity of Great Nicobar Biosphere Reserve and contains a total of 1,760 species of animals and microbes found on the island. This includes 558 terrestrial and 1,209 marine species of animals and microbes. The Great Nicobar Island is a unique biodiversity hotspot of our country. It is a part of Andaman and Nicobar Islands, which is a group of 572 islands located between the Bay of Bengal and the Andaman Sea in the Indian Ocean. There are two national parks on this island, Campbell Bay in the north and Galathea in the south. These are protected forest areas where animals live in their natural habitat that saves them from threats like poaching and deforestation, which helps to preserve them in the long run. Great Nicobar Island is one of the 14 biosphere reserves in India. Its unique geographical features like proximity to the sea, sand beaches, perennially flowing rivers, and dense evergreen forest in the core make Great Nicobar Islands a unique biodiversity hotspot of our country.
There are many endemic as well as threatened species which are known from this particular biosphere reserve. So it's very, very important to conserve many of them. In Andaman Nicobar Islands, more than 9,000 species have been recorded from the terrestrial as well as the marine region, of which 845 species are endemic to Andaman Nicobar Islands.
This place is famous for animals like Nicobar flying fox, Nicobar tree shrew and megapod, which are endemic to this island. Megapod is a flightless bird, which is endemic to this region, is now listed endangered by the International Union for Conservation of Nature. That is, it is facing high risk of extinction in the wild. This is because these birds dwell nests in soil mound on the ground. Due to increased deforestation on the island, their nests are being destroyed and their numbers are continuously reducing. This island is also amongst the best sites for turtle nesting, especially for leatherback, green and hawksbill species of turtles. However, increased sand mining and beach pollution is posing a threat to their breeding sites. The most affected is the Galathea beach on the east coast of Great Nicobar. Scientists believe that improved patrolling on beaches during nesting season and increasing public awareness can help to conserve these animals. Another important concern is poaching of sea cucumbers and seashells by foreign tourists, for which regulation and awareness has to be increased. This book on biodiversity of Great Nicobar Island will serve as a ready reference for scientists, researchers and people engaged in conserving animal species on Great Nicobar Island.
The study is going to become a baseline information for all future studies, and it is hoped that many more species will be described new to these islands in future.
The biodiversity of Great Nicobar Island is now under threat due to human activities like deforestation for agriculture, urban development and unregulated tourism. Loss of biodiversity adversely affects humans because natural systems that support life and livelihoods of many people are at risk when species disappear from the earth. In Great Nicobar Island, for example, the native tribes called Nicobaris depend on forest resources and fishing for their living. Loss of habitat, forests, and biodiversity will be a threat to their survival in the long run. Recording wildlife and environmental conditions of this unique biodiversity hotspot will help organizations engaged in conservation by updating them with current information, which will take us a long way to preserve the wildlife of Great Nicobar Island of our country.
The Ramanujan Fellowship was started by the Science and Engineering Research Board, an autonomous organization under the Department of Science and Technology, Government of India, aims to attract the scientists, the technologists and engineers from across the world to carry out research and take up scientific research positions in India. The fellowship is named after the inspirational Indian mathematician Srinivasa Ramanujan, who made significant contributions to mathematical analysis of number theory, infinite series and continued fractions. Science Monitor brings you a detailed report on this fellowship.
The Ramanujan Fellowship, launched by the Science and Engineering Research Board under the Department of Science and Technology, Government of India, was started in 2006 for Indian scientists who want to return to India from abroad. It aims to attract scientists settled abroad to pursue scientific research in India in their field of expertise and contribute to India's research programs. The fellowship also encourages scientists and researchers to work in areas and laboratories in order to expand their research capabilities. It also provides liberal grants for international travel to enable the scientists to continue scientific collaborations with overseas institutions. Scientists who are below the age of 45 years are eligible for this fellowship. The Ramanujan Fellowship is awarded to researchers, scientists and engineers in all areas of science such as life sciences, chemical science, physical science, mathematics, engineering, etc.
Ramanujan Fellowship is designed for the reverse brain drain. Here, any person who is interested to apply for Ramanujan Fellowship has to be get nominated when he's staying abroad. Ramanujan Fellowship is done by Search Cum Selection Committee, and is based on his publications, impact factor, his contribution to science, and what new science he can initiate in the country when he comes back.
To avail this fellowship, the scientist must have a PhD in science and engineering, or master's in engineering, technology or medicine. The candidates must send their nominations through the head of the organization or university in which they are working. The fellows are given a salary grant of 85,000 rupees per month, in addition to a research grant of rupees 7 lakhs per annum and overhead charge of rupees 60,000 per annum to the host institute. The candidates can approach any science and technology institution, including university departments or other academic institutions and national laboratories in India, to avail the fellowship. The nominations of scientists and engineers by the institutions can be received throughout the year. A search cum selection committee makes the selection of the Ramanujan fellows twice a year. The fellowship is very selective, and individuals with outstanding record of accomplishments with research publications are said to stand a better chance. The duration of the fellowship is for 5 years. For further information, the candidate can visit their website www.serb.gov.in/rnf.php. One of the studies done under the fellowship is by Alok Kumar Rai, a fellow at the Amrita Institute of Medical Sciences in Kochi, who is working on chemical synthesis methods to synthesize conversion-based electrode material for the next generation of lithium-ion batteries. Another fellow, Raja Shammugan, at the Indian Institute of Science Education, Kolkata, is working to develop polymers which have applications in the field of drug delivery and sensors. So far, around 326 scientists and engineers have benefited from the prestigious Ramanujan Fellowship. The fellows, after completing the fellowship work at the prestigious institutes and laboratories in India, like the Indian Institute of Technology, Council of Scientific and Industrial Research, Indian Institute of Science Education and Research, and the Indian Institute of Science.
It's time for another short break, and when we come back, we will bring you some more news on science and innovation from India and around the world. But that's after a short break, so keep watching Science Monitor.
Tales that inspire. Stories of social change. A salute to diversity. Promoting public discourse. Events that motivate. Inspiring the innovative spirit. Watch Rajya Sabha television documentaries.
Welcome back, and let's now take a quick look at some more scientific innovations and developments from India and around the world.
Scientists at the University of California in San Francisco in the US have developed an atlas of human brain and the mapping of gene expression in single cells, which can help in tracking the point of neurological disorders. The study will help to understand the reasons behind different neurodevelopmental disorders like autism, schizophrenia, and intellectual disability. The study was published in the journal Science. A study published in the journal Nature has described a new dinosaur look-alike creature, which is a mix of duck, crocodile, ostrich and swan, has been discovered. The new dinosaur species is named Halskrapter esculi or Halska, after the late Polish paleontologist Halska Osmolska. According to the journal, the 45-centimeter tall species are dated to be of 75 million year old and was found in Mongolia in East Asia. The curled-up skeleton of Halska was found in sandstone rock. The researchers used a synchrotron to create the three-dimensional images of the fossil. In a latest development, researchers have transplanted coral bred in one part of the Great Barrier Reef into another area. The trial was conducted at the reef's Heron Island off Australia's east coast. This will help to restore and repair damaged coral reef's ecosystem, where the natural supply of larvae has reduced. The Great Barrier Reef is facing the brunt of climate change, which is linked to the rise in water sea temperature causing coral bleaching. The father of DNA fingerprints in India, Professor Lalji Singh, passed away on 10th December 2017 at the age of 70. He was an eminent DNA scientist and former vice chancellor of Banaras Hindu University. He worked significantly in the areas of molecular basics of sex determination, wildlife conservation, forensics, and evolution and migration of humans. Lalji Singh was potential in forming the Center for DNA Fingerprinting and Diagnostics in 1995. Scientists at the National Center for Biological Sciences in Bangalore are working on the positioning system of cells in proteins. The study is being conducted on proteins like RDGB. The proteins have their own positioning system that works to guide the cells to understand their functioning and responses. This study will help to cure cancer and other neurodegenerative diseases. The study was published in the Journal of Cell Sciences.
And in the history of science this week, we remember Robert Koch, a German physician born on 11th of December 1843 in Clausthal, Kingdom of Hanover. The renowned physician is known for his contributions in the field of microbiology, which is the study of microorganisms. Koch is regarded as the founder of modern bacteriology. He played an instrumental role in the development of techniques for growing bacteria in laboratory. He used agar to grow and isolate pure cultures. He played a significant role in identifying the causative agents of diseases like tuberculosis, cholera, and anthrax. Koch also improved laboratory technologies and techniques in microbiology for conducting better experiments and researches. For his breakthrough research in tuberculosis, Koch was honored with the prestigious Nobel Prize in Physiology and Medicine in 1905. He was successful in determining the causative agent of tuberculosis to be the slow-growing Mycobacterium tuberculosis. In 1897, Koch became a foreign member of the Royal Society. He passed away on 27th of May 1910 at the age of 66. Robert Koch is remembered as one of the most inspirational scientists across the world. Well, that is all for this episode of Science Monitor. You can send your feedback and suggestions to Science Monitor on our email ID news@viganprasar.gov.in. You can also write in to us at Vigyan Prasar C24, Kutub Institutional Area, New Delhi 110016. We'll see you again next week with another episode of Science News and Innovations. Till then, goodbye and take care.